Greetings to the house. This is Ravleen Kaur and I'm currently pursuing BSc Honours in Zoology from University of Delhi. Beginning with my speech, first of all, I'll give a brief structure of it, which is as follows. First of all, I will be defining all the basic key terms relevant to the motion. Later on, I will be defining my stance and I'll give key arguments relevant to my side of the motion. So beginning with it, first of all, we need to understand what freedom is. Freedom is basically a state wherein every human is access to all the basic human rights. Now, what human rights actually are? Human rights are the rights that are inherent to every human being, irrespective of caste, creed, religion, language, ethnicity, or anything. Those few rights include the right to life and liberty, freedom from oppression, suppression, slavery, and torture, the right to expression and opinion, the right to work and education. And not to mention, all these rights are accessed to every human being, irrespective of any sort of discrimination. And the role of any government is to make sure that all its citizens are having access to all of these rights. Now, coming back to the motion, which states, are we independent? It's basically here referring to the freedom of living in a dignified manner. I don't agree with this. I don't think we are really independent or we are really free. And I will be explaining this in the next part, in the coming part of my speech. So hereby, we will be examining a few disparities that we encounter every day and how we have become so much immune to it and how we turn a blind eye towards all of them. Beginning with the very basic amenity, education. A hell lot of Indian children have no access to education. Now, the opposition will come up and say that it's not true and the government comes up with new schemes every single day. So, these schemes, they look excellent on paper, but the reality is very different. According to a report by NSSO, 32 million Indian children never went to any school. And all of them were majorly the socially disadvantaged ones. Secondly, talking about the another basic amenity, which is sanitation. 82% of Indian rural households have been denied access to the basic sanitation. Even 57% of them have to travel considerable distance of approximately 5 kilometers every single day to get access to clean drinking water. Now, this is my question to everyone present here, striving so much for the basic education, striving so much for the clean drinking water. Is it really called freedom? Are we really free? Anyways, let's talk about the third thing, which is women's safety in India. The people of our land worship Sati, Savitri, Durga, Lakshmi. And on the other hand, the crimes against women keep on increasing every single day. Now, let me tell you an incident. According to a report by Johann Reuter Foundation, which stated India to be the world's most dangerous country, even outranking countries like Syria and Afghanistan. And experts say that it is all because of the negligence on the part of our government. Now, after mentioning so much of these examples, I think we are not really, really independent and we are still in a striving phase. Thank you.